Okay, the frame is up pretty much. Tim's working on one end. That's going to be clear plastic coated. And then the door will be at that end. And I just want to show what he's doing on every seam or every part that's got a rough spot. He's coating it with this vet wrap. And so the plastic doesn't get ripped as it slides over it. Which is pretty darn smart.
Well, these are have some carpet under them, too. Wrapping carpet.
Carpet and that. Like padding, or?
Well, it was just leftover indoor outdoor carpet, about 3 inch wide strip, and I wrapped that, and then I wrapped the vet wrap. These are just vet wrap.
You are such a smart man, Forrest.
Yeah, I'm a fart smeller.
Instead of a smart fella. I'm going to peek up here. And the whole thing is put together with the farmer's secret weapon, zip ties. Love that.
Well, there's these, too.
Oh, yeah, those. Those you use to attach one stock panel to the other. These have been around for a while. A little bit rusty.
I repurposed those.
Aren't you using a trendy term?
Actually, I reused them because the last time we used them for that same purpose.
They're just getting reused the same place. Here's his... Do you call these furring strips? What do I call those?
Yeah, they're not really furring strips. Mm. They're 2x2s.
Okay, 2x2s. There's his 2x2s holding panel against the boxes. They're resting in that one that he made a groove in down there. And then he put this on above to hold it in place all the way down. And then, right on this side, the panels are, I'm going to have to go on the inside to show you. But yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Go on the other side. Now these panels are kind of floating, so to speak, and attached to the T-posts. And what he did is he put bricks under here to hold the panel while he attached it. And how he attached it was just taking wire. I don't know if you can see that from the other side, and wrapping it around on either side of the T-post. Hopefully you can get that.
The same thing on the top of the post too, but you can't see those.
Yeah, but he's got those covered. Are you going to cover those too down at the bottom?
No, I shouldn't have to.
Because it'll be looser? Is that what you mean?
The plastic won't.
Won't be as tight as up here?
What I really covered at the top was the actual top of the T-post, because they've got the three nice sharp
top of the T-post right here. Oh yeah, that, yeah, those are nasty.
Of the
plastic. Huh. Now, to attach or to put the plastic over the house, what we're going to do is drape the plastic over and get hay bales. Hopefully last year's old cheap hay bales. And we're going to lay the hay bales on top of the plastic to hold it in place on either side of the arch. So the plastic will come down and then lay on the ground with a hay bale over it. And as those hay bales get wet, they'll get heavier and eventually they'll break down. So in the spring, when we want to roll the sides up and or take the plastic right off, we can use all those old hay bales for mulch. That's the plan anyway. We'll see how well it works. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm still hacking. So, when we get the plastic on, I will add to this video. Well, the plastic is on, or in the process of going on. Tim's working on the end. We had a roll that was 28 feet wide by 52 feet long. I bought this 3 years ago, so I was at the time thinking the greenhouse was going to be twice as wide and we'd be using two stock panels to go over instead of one, so that's why it's so much wider. But lengthwise we didn't have too much left over actually. And then we've got our hay bales that are going to hopefully secure it down for the winter with the plastic underneath. And the one end is just going to be all plastic. We aren't going to have doors at both ends. Keep it simple, stupid, you know, the kids' formula. So this is just going to be all plastic at this end, and it'll be making it look neater. Still getting raspberries. Take a look. I have to tell you about the brilliant thing my husband came up with a paint roller. We had the roll of plastic. We could lift it up and we could get it on top, but then to roll it out, we weren't tall enough. So you got paint rollers with an extension on it. We slid those into the end of the roll on either side, and then we could lift it up at the same time, and we just walked down the length of the greenhouse, unrolling the plastic as we went. Boy, it's windy. I hope you don't get too much wind noise. And it worked like a charm. My brilliant, brilliant husband. I never would have thought of that. But so if you're unrolling plastic on top of a too tall greenhouse, paint rollers. Okay, Tim is in the process of adding a cleat, that piece of wood. I've just learned what that's called, to hold the plastic down. He's already cut the door into the plastic, or he's going to rough cut it. The door opens in. He has the door already hung. I'll show you that when he's all done. I'll show it closed. So the door is opening inward, because if there's a bunch of snow out here, we don't want to have to open it out into the snowdrift. And that's the only thing we're going to have to watch is make sure the snow falls off. Now, I can envision that when the snow falls off, it's going to land on these old hay bales here. And I don't know how tall it will get, but maybe it'll just... Ooh, there he's got my cough. It'll just add more insulation. I don't know, but this is the first year. We will see. By the way, this plastic is called, it's upside down, but it's called Sunmaster. I don't remember where I got it, but it's Farm Tech? Okay, I got it from the Farm Tech catalog, and it's 6 mil, I think. Yep. Really heavy duty stuff. It's supposed to last, I think, 3 years. We will be taking it off in the spring, and then I want to reuse it. He's not sure we can. I think we can. Or maybe at the very least, unrolling this, rolling the sides in some way, shape, or form. But I think we'll just take it off because it's just held on by the hay bales. These are very heavy hay bales. They were this year's hay, but whoever baled them did a good job. And because it's first cutting and not the greatest, it's kind of weedy. I got it for $2 or $2.50 a bale. Would have liked to find $1 mulch hay, but the problem with finding hay bales that are too old is the strings. If they use the sisal string instead of the plastic twine, is your strings will break. So they're really hard to use because you'll be moving them and picking them up and then they break. So I'd rather have fresher bales that are easy to move around. And then it'll make for some really nice mulch in the spring. So we'll come back when we get the door all done. I am just itching to put a thermometer in here. It is 60 degrees outside, and I can't wait to see what it is inside, even though it's overcast today. I'm betting it's going to get at least up to 70, maybe even 75 in there. Maybe even warmer. I don't know. Like I say, this is new territory, having a high tunnel or a hoop house or unheated greenhouse, whatever you want to call it. So I'm ecstatically excited, and I'm also excited because Tim is excited about this. You know, it's kind of fun when one of my harebrained ideas that he has to make happen when he gets excited about it too. He actually wanted to do PVC as a framework, and I said, no, we want stock panels. They're really strong, and he had some trepidation about it, so I said, okay, we'll try the stock panels because we have them, or we had some of them. And if it doesn't work, we can replace it. So we went along with that idea, but now he really likes these stock panels because they are very strong. Okay, we're at the front door, and Tim is putting the plastic around the door, and he's making pleats. And it's very important that you make the pleats, or the folds, so that they're down. So when the rain comes, it hits it and goes right down, doesn't fall into a pocket. So you want to fold, make your folds down. Which I probably wouldn't have thought of, but of course Mr. Engineer Brain did. So, okay, I just thought I'd show you what I've got in here. I trimmed the ground cherries back. I may take them out, but it just killed me to do it. And I'm not so sure I don't have a bunch of babies coming up. I don't know. Because these things don't get weeds, generally speaking. So I bet you those are the babies everybody told me I was going to get. Now, I have had ground cherries in the garden, a regular garden. I've never had volunteers. I think we just get too cold. But maybe in the boxes, that will be a different case. I did plant these already, and I didn't have trouble with chickens getting in them all summer until I planted them for fall. And then I looked out, and there were my chickens digging in the corners and throwing things every which way. So much for my rows and my trying to be neat here. But so I've got my little plants coming up all over the place, and that's okay. And I think I have beets in here. I know, I should have written it down. I don't remember. But we'll find out. In here, obviously, I've got carrots. And I put parsnips along the back. Yeah, these are scarlet and nantus or whatever. Carrots in front. I have parsnips in the back. I don't know if any of them made it. I'm just going to see if this cauliflower does anything. If not, the chickens will love it midwinter. And I've got to trim my basil back. I should just take it out because it's pretty much spent. I love the basil. I love the smell. And what did I... maybe I planted the parsnips back here. I did. I planted parsnips back there. I don't know if they'll come up, but we're going to just see. My seed was kind of old. No, it was this year's seed because you can't use old parsnip seed. It just doesn't last. Everything else does. This is mesclun. You know, the greens mix. And they're all coming up rather nicely, even though there's a deep pocket now. Thank you, chickens. And over here I have, sorry guys, this thing has a lens cap and it gets in my way. Over here I have bok choy, little mini bok choys, and kale. Now I had kale towards the back and the bok choys towards the front. And the chickens, of course, rearranged it. And it's way too thick in here, but I'll deal with that later. Over here I have spinach, and I used some old seed, so I'm going to probably replant this into spinach. And of course then the carrots at the end. So that's what I've got going in here. If I take the ground cherries or the basil out in the front, I will put more spinach. My family loves spinach. And I think spinach would do really well in a greenhouse type situation like this. But I might leave one plant of ground cherries in the corner, just to see how long I can keep them going. Okay, and it is 80 degrees in here, folks. The sun comes out and goes away and comes out and goes away. So it's 60 outside, 80 inside. And I'm sweating because I got lost the sweater, but I'm still in long sleeves. So isn't that wonderful? The one thing we goofed on, we should have weed whipped the aisle here before we put the plastic along the sides, because now if we weed whip, we're going to tear up the plastic. So we're going to have to figure out how to get rid of these weeds in the walkway, because they will like the greenhouse all winter long too, probably. So, and I'm really flirting with the idea of turning some quail loose in here, like Dirt Patch Heaven, like Julianne did in her greenhouse. I really like that. So I might do that, just for fun. Okay, let me show you the door. Here's the little greenhouse door with the latch. And as I mentioned before, it sticks up a little bit. Ah. All right, I'm going to kick it. Don't tell Tim. And it opens inside. Now you're going to notice a lip here. And that is going to make it so you can't get through with a wheelbarrow. But it's a narrow door anyway. But what I use in the garden frequently, like to take compost and stuff in, is this thing. This little cart on wheels. And it certainly is going to fit through the door just fine. I might have to lift it over the lip, but it's never filled so full that I can't lift it. And then I can just scoot it right down the aisle. So might as well leave that in here. So I'll be filling some boxes up. So there is my little scooty cart that I'll be using in here to put more compost in the boxes or leaves or whatever I want to do. So isn't that cool, guys? That is just so cool. I am so pleased. And there goes the last of the plastic along the sides. This is the south side of the greenhouse. And that's doesn't have the boxes, so there's light all the way down to the hay bales. I'm standing at the east side. Here's the north side. We got to get the plastic out of there yet. And of course at the far end would be the west side. So That's the way it's oriented. And it's 32 feet? 32 feet? What, 29? Okay, we'll say 29, 30 feet long and 6 feet, right? 6.5 feet wide. And Tim is 5'11" and stand up. He's got to duck a little bit to go in the door, but it's plenty tall for him to walk in through there. So,
yeah, so
my little bee's up there. There's the bee. I don't know if I got him in the shot or not. The bees are still pretty active. So, yeah, here, let me show you. Yeah, they are very active today. And I'm standing right in their flight path. So, I don't have any idea how much honey they've got stored in this thing, but I think it's going to be good for winter. And once the days do get colder and they're not as busy, I'll knock this thing down for the winter. It's not going to be this tall over the winter. Give them probably 2 brood boxes and maybe 2 honey boxes. They've got 3 brood boxes right now. So, okay, guys. That's all, but for all intents and purposes, we have to work on this west wall a little bit. But the greenhouse is up and done, and being it's 80 degrees in there, it's working pretty well on an overcast day. I have to show you our trees. This is a sugar maple. It is October 15th, and maybe we're getting a little yellow on the elm tree, but the maples, there's silver maples over there. The sumac is turning a little red, but I cannot believe we don't have more color, guys. It's just starting to turn, and usually we'd be in peak color, and we also haven't had a hard frost. So it's been a very unusual year. They're saying a hard winter, but it's not getting off to a big start here.